Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was another earthquake there in the New Madrid fault zone, the seismic zone. This one was a magnitude 3.4, and USGS said it was a 3.2. It was located in the St. Francois Mountain volcanic zone, which I got drawn out in yellow. And I've talked about this area in the past, how eons ago, this was actually a volcanic island out there in the ocean at one time. And yeah, I thought that was interesting. One, that it's a volcanic area or a past volcanic area. And the seismic signature from two different monitors. Those of you that follow me should recognize this lack of data between the earthquake. Let's go to the seismic signature for this one and this one. I'll show you where I downloaded that data from. Kind of to the southeast. Here's the two stations, VROM and BRNM. Now this earthquake is listed as Missouri. It was at 12:44 p.m. late last night. USGS has 68 people that said they felt it. My cats were really active, acting up at this time last night. Just running through the house. My one cat I call my earthquake kitty was running through the house, meowing and meowing. Yeah, one of them went in the bathroom and tore up all the toilet paper. Another one actually jumped on my face trying to wake me up. So they have an intensity level of 4. Let me bring it over so you can see it. Which means it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. At night, some people would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling. Automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. It was felt as far as St. Louis. Look at that, intensity level 2. Another 2. Looks like they're all 2. We got over here. Whiteman Air Force Base. Yeah. Like I said, it was actually a magnitude 3.4. Southeast is Jackson. What else do we have here? Let me bring it out a little bit. Yeah, St. Louis is a little concerning. There's a lot of areas over there. Which could turn into basically quicksand, liquefaction. Yeah. Now you know that the earthquake in 1811, 1812, yeah, that caused a lot of damage. Made the church bells there in Boston ring. Yeah. So let me close this out. And I noticed that prior to this earthquake, yeah, there was quite a few small earthquakes, popping of the ground, probably about 12 hours earlier. I don't know if you can see them. Let me make this one bigger. Hold on. I just picked one out, and let's extract that and make that bigger. Rounded tops. Magma. Yeah, that's magma. This earthquake was fairly shallow. Only 5.1 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Let's take a look at this. Yeah, because that's normally, yep. See, that's normally the signature of blobs of magma coming into the system. Now, the New Madrid fault area, that is a failed rift system. Rift systems are pull-apart basins where, let me pull this up. Yeah, where often volcanic activity goes on. And I've talked about past volcanoes, in this area. Yeah, I want to jump around here at some of these smaller ones if I can find them. Hold on. So we got one there. Let's look at its seismic signature. Is it there? A real tiny one there. Let's close this out. Let's see, I got another one way up over here. Well, actually, it looks like three of them there. Yeah, 8:03 and 45 seconds. That would be 2:03 a.m. And there's a whole bunch of small little drum beats in there. I don't know if I can make that bigger or not. Yeah, there we go. Look at them all. It's like, wow. And it probably went on for, close to 20 minutes, it looks like. Let's take a look at the seismic signature. We actually got a line of melt. Wow. Okay. And then there's some more down here. We'll go to its signature. 10:36. That would be 4:36 a.m. This morning. Yeah, there's a series of them there. And then all of a sudden the, gushing came in. Let's look at the signature. Yeah, interesting, isn't that? I thought it is. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files just a little while ago. Yeah, I don't see too many drum beats. Just a lot of little stuff. And then over here, let me pull it over. Okay, that's the one monitor. And this is B-R-O-O-M. Well, yep, look at that. Should automatically recognize that signature. Holy cow. 12:24, but there's more recent. Let's see, and that's universal time. Okay, the more recent would be 12:30. Let me bring this over. You see how the data is missing? Let me make that bigger. Okay. And we'll go to the spectrogram. Now, that would be 12:30 universal, 6:30 a.m., and it went on for how long? About a minute there, and then we got another little gusher there. Okay, and let's pull this over, and I'll show you that other activity, which is over here. And we'll go to the seismic signature. This is all new activity. I haven't seen this. No, not for the new Madrid fault system. No, I have not seen this before. Look at all that. Yep, hot water came up here. Yeah, a little concerning. Let me go back to Google Earth. Okay, here's the two monitors. This is that volcanic area. And then over here we have Hicks Dome. And those of you that follow me, some of you might be new. But this here is an ancient volcano right here. Hicks Dome. And it was basalt type of intrusion. And back in 92, there was magnetic anomalies, which is often an indication of, volcanism. I did have drawn out. Let me see here. Oh, up over here. Dike intrusions were, there was a crack in the ground and lava came up. There we go. And I got them drawn out in green. Different little areas that I found where it was, dike intrusions. And then over there, this is ancient little cracks of lava. You can actually follow it along. Yeah. Those two of you that have been following me know that the last time when we had a major flip of the Earth's magnetic field, we had an increase in volcanism. There was an increase in earthquakes, major earthquakes. And as our Earth's magnetic field weakens, we're going to see more and more of that. It also does affect the weather. And we have seen that lately with the jet stream. Yep, and we're going to see more and more of that with the weather and earthquakes and tornadoes and all that stuff. The magnetic field is weakening so fast now, they no longer post what the current level of our magnetic field is. Which also means that when the sun has an eruption, it's going to affect the Earth more. And yeah, people have asked, do these CMEs, coronal mass ejections coming off the sun, do they affect the Earth with earthquakes? Yes, they do. If a certain area is prone to an earthquake, yeah, it will trigger it. Like I said, it also affects our weather. All new things that we are seeing globally around the world. So what are your thoughts? Please put your information, your thoughts down below. Make sure you're still subscribed. YouTube has been unsubscribing people from multiple channels. I've heard other channels talk about how people are being unsubscribed. So make sure you're still subscribed. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for following me. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.